I'm live. Bear with me. I am setting all this up for the first time, and I got to find a good mic placement. I guess I'll do this. I'll play here, and I'll look over and talk here. Volume for myself, and I'm also testing. I'm testing my streaming stuff going on here with the video games. I have a kind of a complex setup, so and I'm also testing for the first time on Twitch. So I got to look at my Twitch stream and see that I'm actually streaming. And I guess, is my voice kind of low here? Or is that good? Audio input, camera, and voice. So I haven't tested fully the levels. Put the mic down a little bit. I don't know if it actually is working to Twitch. So I'm looking at my Twitch, and I just see a blank screen there. Oh, wait, I think I see me on Twitch. Live now. SparkDead is streaming. Watch now. Oh, okay. I see it on Twitch. It's different. It's new for me, so just making sure. Doing its thing. Yeah, we'll let that go on Twitch, and I'll go back and make adjustments as needed for the next time. All right, so a little, let's monitor the melon here. So a little info about what's going on, my setup, and what I'm playing right now. Now I'm going to adjust my screen size when I play. So I have my classic games. In this case, it's Nintendo 64, going through an analog to digital converter to HDMI into an HDMI. You know what? I need to. Into an HDMI capture card, which goes to the USB in the computer. Once it's digitized and on the PC, I'm using something, a free software called OBS Studio, to take the video feed of the video games and overlay the video feed from my phone as webcam through wireless Wi-Fi, through iRyun, whatever it's called, webcam app, which when connected to Wi-Fi, I'm able to use that as my webcam. I have a microphone directly plugged into the PC, so I'm taking the audio from this mic and from Nintendo 64, splicing all that together in OBS Studio, sending that signal to Melon app, which is simulcasting, sending that stream out to YouTube, Facebook, and now Twitch. And I do see a delay in all my video feeds. I have three monitors all here. One is monitoring the direct feed of the game. One I have OBS Studio, and that one looks, so there's a delay between OBS and Melon. So if the audio is not syncing up, I am sorry for that. I can fix that through OBS. It has time delay features. However, I don't know how to do all that yet. So volume feels low. Okay. Is the volume low? There. How is the audio now? Is the audio a little bit better? A little worse? Is there any buzzing on the audio? That's another question. So how is it there? there. Better. Okay. Is it good enough to go like this? Can you hear the video game? You can hear my voice. No buzzing. All right. So that is some background on the setup, the technical setup of streaming. And the game itself tonight is Nintendo 64. Can hear your voice, but no game. All right, right now there's no audio. There we go. How's that on the game? Should be able to hear music right now. And should I turn that up? Good? Okay. I'll go with this. If I need to adjust a few things later, I will. So the game itself is a ROM hack. There are companies and individuals out there making new games for old systems. They're also taking existing games and hacking them and modding them and releasing it on physical cartridges. So I do play everything on the physical. It's no emulation. This is a cartridge on an actual Nintendo 64. Here's my controller. I didn't test if this controller will reach. And it will. Yay! Volume on voice up higher. Go up higher. Get all the way up. Yeah, I'm all the way up on my voice right now. I can see the level, and the level shows it in the red when I speak like this. Sometimes with this mic, I have to be right next to it, though, so that could be it if I'm over here. So this particular ROM hack is GoldenEye, James Bond GoldenEye for Nintendo 64, one of the most legendary games for Nintendo 64, and they put in Mario 64 characters, so two of the best games together. I used to love playing GoldenEye all the time and Mario 64. However, I have not played either in a really long time. And in fact, when I got this ROM hack was over a year ago, I played it like once or twice and have not really played it. So if anyone starts following my game streams, do not follow it expecting an expert or expert gameplay or how-tos, because I'm going to fumble my way through everything, trying to remember old games I'm playing and figure out new games that I'm just trying out. So it's not going to be an expert game. It's going to be just someone goofing around. That's what we're here for. All right, so let's play. I can I don't know exactly where to put my picture in picture yet. Keep myself in the top corner. and let's play. It looks like since this is a hack, I think everything is just unlocked already. But let's start at the beginning. Oh, I might have already beat this one. So in GoldenEye, the difficulties, if you beat certain times and marks on each difficulty, you unlock different things. We'll just start at the easiest and go from there. Bully Blue? What's blue? Everything looks like it's going on. All
Robert Keane. Good comments. Thank you, Robert. So let's play.
All right. I have to bungee jump, and you would expect playing this if you have experience. You're going to be James Bond.
You can see the blob. The Koopa Troopers. Look at them. Mario with a gun. How cool is that? Come on.
All right. I don't even remember the controls. So, again, I have the backwards controls. Okay. Let's make an adjustment here.
This is what I'm looking for.
All right, that's better. I like pulling back on the stick to look up like an airplane.
Strafe.
Mario's glovy hand. What's this?
Mario with a machine gun.
It looks a little grainy on the feed. I think there's some loss in quality going to the conversion to digital.
It's funny that boxes explode. I mean.
Why are they wearing sunglasses?
I mean, they should have Bowser at the end of the stages, but I guess they can't change the gameplay.
Susie says the volume is low. Does anyone concur?
Forgot to go in the towers, and I think there's body armor in one of them, I remember. Some things you remember even after many, many years, right? But I could be wrong. Probably in that other tower.
Indeed low. Low on the game or my voice or both?
It looks like I can turn.
Turn the game up.
you know, if it's not optimized, then I'll have to figure out and adjust that stuff another time offline. Troopers, I know there's secrets over here, but I don't have to do that. Carrying machine guns, shoot at Mario. The animation at the end, if I remember, was decent. Mario should do more dangerous missions, right? But I do see on my meter in the melon feed that it does look low. Go to the facility. Remember the facility? Troopers pooping. Pooper trooper. Look at their feet. Ah, come on. The thing with GoldenEye, from what I remember, I I mean, the multiplayer is always where it's at, right? And me and my buddies used to play that a lot. And you get to know the levels, like every corner, every wall. What a wall looks like if someone's trying to hide. You play multiplayer and you're like this, so they don't find you by looking at your screen. But, you know, you play so much you can recognize. I got a key card back there or shouldn't be too hard. Why does the lockers explode? You ever go to the gym and you slam your locker and it just blows up on you? I mean, that's the worst. Agent, stop coming in and check it. Is that a scientist? He's crying. Aw, poor guy. I like his purple shell. He's like kind of a magenta or... Look at him run! So in the original GoldenEye, I think one of the scientist characters on this level was... Oh, that's a scientist there. Oh, it's... it's just got a babushka. Yeah, one of the game designers or developers was the characters in this game with his face. You know, they mapped their faces and put themselves in. So it's hard. I mean, usually in regular GoldenEye, you see the lab coats and you know, don't shoot them. In this, it's a Koopa with a bush gun. Without sunglasses, I guess. So if you wear sunglasses, you're a bad guy. Now I believe on the harder ones you gotta get a key card from one of these guys or something like that. I forget. Of remember, I think I have to go to the left, but I want to explore around. You get one of those guys. Go in there to open the door. There's those people that do the speed runs, and it's nuts. They fly through these in seconds. That way or that way? Ah. I mean, whoever hacked this and did this, they do it so well to the point where I think it's just the character changes, right? Just a but with the Game Shark, which I do have, and not even the Game Shark, they would put all the cheats built into the game that you unlock. The DK mode, which makes your body look like Donkey Kong and Big Heads, and a whole bunch of different cheats and things built right into the game. So I guess it's not too far of a stretch to do something like this. And 3 bullets on this gun left. That's great. I guess Code takes place of the scientist I was talking about. You know what? I don't even know what my objectives are. Rendezvous with 002? 006, Trevelyan. Destroy all. So all that takes place at the end. My scientist casual. Mario's 001, and we're going to see who 002 is. I mean, James Bond is 007, so I guess, you know, you're not playing James Bond, you're Mario, so you're 001. Hey, guys. Part of me feels bad shooting them, but it's the game. Guys, feel free to leave comments on some games you'd like to see. Now, I don't own a whole lot. But how about systems? I have NES, Super NES, Nintendo 64, GameCube, Genesis, and Xbox 360. Let me know what kind of systems you would want to see me play the most. Yes! Of course it's Luigi. Of course. Hey, Luigi. For Brooklyn. Instead of for England, like they say in GoldenEye, in the movie, it's for Brooklyn. Luigi. Come on, that is great. There's Bowser. Oh no! Bowser just shot Luigi. Ah. So there's yeah. Yes, I made it. Did I complete all the objectives? I should play Minecraft. I can play Minecraft one time. Not tonight. I won't play Minecraft tonight. But, oh yes, I did complete everything. Woohoo! So I do have Minecraft on PC and Xbox, so I can. And that might be interesting, because I haven't really played and figured out Minecraft. So maybe I could do it as a newbie. And so Maybe I set myself a goal of how long it takes me to learn the game and get to the Ender Dragon and get the Ender Pearl. That would be cool. Thank you, Olive, for that suggestion. And also I have to figure out how long I want to stream. You know, how long should these videos be? Oh, yeah. It depends. My phone is my webcam, and I don't have that plugged in, so it depends on the battery. Also, before I go on to the next level, I'll play some more. I've had insomnia the past couple weeks, or a couple nights, and I suffer. I've had insomnia almost my entire life, so I've been sleep deprived. And I think tonight, right now, I slipped some whiskey. I don't know if I should say that. I slipped some whiskey in my Coke that I got from Burger King. I don't suggest everyone do this. I am good with drinks like this. It doesn't bother me. Social drink. But I need a little help to fall asleep tonight. And in a little bit, I will take a supplement with melatonin. Called the Neuro Restore dietary supplement. Natural sleep support promotes relaxation, natural sleep, may reduce time needed to fall asleep. That's what I want. Actually, I'll take that now so it kicks in. Olive, would you play Minecraft with me and show me how things are done? Pills do stink. They may make my hands stink. So I did download a program, but I haven't used it yet to create your own NES games, and I hope to get some free time eventually to do that. I've never done any game design, but that would be cool. Alright, so OHMSS, Ohms. Ohms. Find plane ignition key and escape in the play. This is the runway. Is it this one? There's a bunch of like secret things and myths about this game. And, back in the day, I know people thought their cartridge was haunted, and stuff like that. Yeah, I'm looking at the feed. Can we do it? It's 001 up to the task. I like these little cutscenes. Mario with a gun! Nintendo does not endorse this. Yeah.
I know there's a way with rocket launchers and grenades to boost yourself with speedrunners. They do that. You run like run down to a wall and it makes you run faster. I'm not. I have to find the airplane's ignition key. Hey, buddies. The table blows up. Come on. There we go. Ignition. All trying to make them fly like on 007, like on GoldenEye. They have guys have an animation to fly from an explosion to the air. Is that General Orimov that was played by Bowser? Alright, made it to the So, one of the best things about this is multiplayer. You can play, like, as Peach, Mario, Luigi, Yoshi, Bowser, I guess. So, you can run around and Yoshi has a gun and you see them on screen. You come around a corner and, you know what? I don't have anyone to play with here, but I will show you. Spawn monsters on peaceful or creative mode. We can do that. Olive is going to play with me sometime. That'll be great. I would love that. So, how long have I been? About 40 minutes. I think I'm going to switch over to show some multiplayer, even though I don't have anyone here to play with. Actually, I had an idea for a device. I know there's other ways to play online, and this one a backwards way, and would have the problem of latency or lag. But you can, they do make controllers. You can do it for any system, but let's say Nintendo 64. They have Nintendo 64 USB controllers to map and play on your PC. Through, like, robot or machine control software, you can take the input signal of a controller and output it to control motor, right? Or it make any signal generator. So what if you can then stream the signal of your controller through USB and someone else playing through the internet, they are streaming your controller input signals and you take that opposite and go from USB from that signal, convert it into Nintendo 64 language, and plug it into your Nintendo 64. So remotely through the internet, they can control the controller ports on play through the internet on one system, and then you can just stream the video feed, and they can watch it, so you can play it. Oh, that's an idea. But yeah, let's go. I know there's only a few people watching. It says unstable internet. There's probably lag and all types of things. That's okay. Only a few people watching. But if anyone has, even on the clip, it's a Koopa Trooper. If you have any request of any of these levels, I will play them when I come back. Otherwise, we'll go and I'll show you the multiplayer level. This was a secret aspect of the different levels there. So if you want to see any of these levels, then great. If not, we're going to just show some multiplayer. Let's check the key options. Oh, they do have decode. YouTube, so we could have the bigger screen. Look, Peach's Castle. I think that's Ba-Bomb's Battlefield, the Haunted Mansion. These are Nintendo 64 or a Mario 64 levels. And then we have the 007. Let's go 5 minutes. Yeah, rockets. Alright, here we go. We got Daisy, Bowser, Yoshi. I want to be Pauly. I don't know who Pauly is. Who's Pauly? We got Wario. We got DK. I'm going to be here. Toad, they could have used Odd Job. Hello, Bobby. Yes, we're inside the castle. This is great. And now, if you played Mario 64, you can know the levels by the other person's screen. I gotta get back. She has some weird looking hands. Oh, yeah. Alright, so it looks like the mirror room upstairs. I forget exactly where that mirror is, but I do need weapons. I don't think it follows the same weapons layout, loadout that GoldenEye does. It just seems more sparse with weapons. Oh.
Did I do it? Anything's down here. I need some support. Did I see if I can go down there? What do you think will happen if I try and go into this pit? Anyone? Anyone want to chime in? Won't even go in. She's coming to get you, buddy. Now he's in the basement, under a minute to go. Let's check out some of the other levels. We got two other Mario levels. Battlefield and the Haunted Mansion. Let's some Donkey Kong. Enjoyable for anyone to me. And yeah, it looks stretched on the screen. I might have to take a look at that. Not bad. So we got Bomb Battlefield here. Oh. The trees are flattened though. Look at that. So it's not exactly 64 level. I don't know. Maybe they try to recreate it instead of using the actual assets from Mario. And they just did the best they could. And I think I know where Bowser is. It's not like I need to pick any of these items up. How is it without being able to jump? Yeah, it doesn't look like anything's moving. And there's Koopa. Yes, he's standing in flowers. Look, aww, Bowser. Did anyone like this design, this version of Bowser? Very little hair. I know the more modern versions, he looks more menacing. This, I guess it was the first 3D version. So. Look at this time. Bad guy, so. Now look where he spawned. He's in some random corner. I gotta try and find him. But we're playing Mario 64's Ba-Bomb Battlefield. I am Donkey Kong with the gun playing GoldenEye multiplayer. Like, come on, that's crazy, right? So he's probably over here. Now, only if it had more of the mechanics for Mario where I can get a star and ride the turtle shell around and the wing hat and all that stuff. That would be great. Ah, there it is. Hey, buddy. Here's Donkey Kong. Here to slide around. And not sure who is that. Slap. I look, the arm in front of my screen has a white glove on it. So. Bowser, you better get my money. Give me that money. Poor Bowser. Oh, where is he now? How you guys doing tonight? Anyone else playing some games tonight? It's that time. It's my first time streaming games, so see how it goes. Should we see how the Haunted Mansion is or anything? What should we call it? 5 minutes for maybe an hour. So let's try one more. I will, let's do Princess versus Princess. Yeah, 5 minutes left. Thank you, everyone, for joining me. If you do like this, please, you know, give a thumbs up, leave a comment, share it if you want. So I am somewhat familiar with this mansion. It's from Mario 64. And it almost looks like the lower screen is up in the attic. And I am in one of the side wings. If you remember, there's that tiny cage in the garden, and there's a mansion that Mario goes in to fight Big Boo and all that. And I am! Woohoo! And I didn't get any luck. Hi, Daisy. Got a problem. We found out you've been skimming money from Toad. Isn't gonna fly. Time running out yet? Operation Finding Snuff Her Out. Her dress incomplete? Oh, they don't want you to look at it. Good animation when they run, you can see, you know, her like moving the dress. You see Princess Peach in the red. Oh, now she's in that room with no people. Thank you. Oh, well.
So. So I want to thank everyone for joining me, and you know, this has been a good test. I'll go back and watch the footage and see what I need to adjust, you know, audio, video wise, technical wise, and see if this. I know it shows I only have 4 viewers right now. E-Dud and Brandon. Brandon's been here a while, but E-Dud just came in right when I'm about to sign off. I was playing a hack of GoldenEye with Mario 64 characters on original hardware, streamed. So, Mario Nintendo 64. And I'll see if what the response, if people do want this. I'll check out Twitch, see if that works. I don't understand Twitch. I don't frequent it often, so I'll have to figure that out. And if it seems like all is good, I'll do more of this. And if not, I know even... 12B Talk last night was talking about how on YouTube the algorithms and they like to support consistent channels, channels that do similar content from video to video. This could be killing my YouTube channel by adding video games on top of car audio. But it's already been, I only average like 200 views on a stream and don't get much on my edited videos, so why not? I'm going to do it. It's fun. Then if it's too hard to do, then I'll stop. But or if it seems like it's blowing up on its own thing, then I'll branch it off. So, but I do appreciate you coming by and checking this out. And, we'll get some suggestions for next time. I did get one suggestion to stream Minecraft. So that's a possibility. I have this set up to do all my classic games. NES, Super NES, Nintendo 64, GameCube, Sega Genesis, and Xbox 360. I can put a list of my games somewhere and see if we get suggestions or requests for any of the games that I have. This has been Spark Ed. I'm Ed. And Ed Games. I was gaming. I do game. Ed does game. Ed Games. So we're going to sign off, and thank you again. If you're watching this after it's been live and you've made it this far, please consider a thumbs up and consider subscribing and sharing. And we'll see you guys next time. All right. Have a good night. End stream.